The Honourable the Deputy Speaker.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and I'll just take a 6 or 7 minutes here to stand and speak to this PMR today that's being introduced on social enterprise. Excited and happy to see that the Government of Newfoundland and Labrador, to support the Government of Newfoundland and Labrador's initiative to build on the hard work and success of the social enterprise sector in our province by implementing a social enterprise action plan, including long-term strategic goals supported by an annual work plan in 2017. And Mr. Speaker, this afternoon we've been hearing a number of examples of successful social enterprises around the province, and I represent a rural district with lots of challenges, some very remote communities, isolated communities, but we have had several success stories around social enterprise, and my colleague for Straits White Bay North, I don't think it's called that now, is it? St. Fair-Blanche Meadows just reminded me of the Moulder of Dreams. I have a community in my district that unfortunately has a very large population of people with Mitonia. And so Moulder of Dreams was a very successful social enterprise and contributed much to their quality of life and gave employment to people that may not have otherwise gotten it. Then we have the Battle Harbour, Harbourview Manor in Mary's Harbour, the only level 2 care home that's in my district. A couple of women sitting around her kitchen saw a need with aging demographics, people getting older, and decided that, let's pull together a board of directors and let's see if we can get a home in this area. And I think right now that home has 19 residents from around my district. And the beauty of that, Mr. Speaker, is their family live within an hour, 2 hours away. These people didn't have to leave the place that they called home all their lives and go somewhere else where family couldn't visit them. Because of the social enterprise and the efforts of volunteers in the area, they're in the home and the family is able to come and visit them on a regular basis. But I really want to focus for the next few minutes, Mr. Speaker, on the Labrador Fishermen's Union Shrimp Company. What a legacy. What an astounding success. Myself and the Minister for Fisheries, Forestry and Agri-Foods are just back from attending the 35th annual general meeting. 35 years back in, I think it was 1978, that the then Minister of the day, Romeo LeBlanc, he made the bold but right decision to give 2 licenses to our area. Couple of fishermen got together, Mr. Speaker, to say, what can we do with those 2 licenses to best help this area that is so economically challenged? And today, Mr. Speaker, 35 years later, this company realizes annual revenues in the amount of almost $90 million a year. $90 million a year. The Labrador Fishermen's Union, what a success story. Between the land and the sea, the employment that they provide to my district is around 1,200 people. They run, operate 5 processing facilities. The largest land processing facility that they operate is in my community in Charlottetown, the only shrimp processing facility in Labrador, a major employer just at one plant in that little area, and it provides employment to a number of communities in the surrounding area, Mr. Speaker. So I think that the shrimp company, we've been talking about different examples of social enterprise, and I wanted to put a human face on this. I think they're a shining example of how things can and should work and the incredible success that can be achieved when people come together and work as one region. So we're very proud of the shrimp company and the countless economic and community benefits because, Mr. Speaker, not only did they come together and use these couple of licenses to benefit the region right from Lanseclair to Cartwright, but time don't permit me to talk about all of the successful things they've done. The first thing they did, the Bank of Montreal had pulled out of the region. They were starting a company. We had no banking institution anywhere, so they provided the initial investment for the Eagle River Credit Union, which is now one of the 7 most successful branches in Canada, which also has revenue of over $95 million. So I often wonder, did the Bank of Montreal wish they had stayed at that time? And Mr. Speaker, the list of what they do to support the community with the They had lost some members in a plane crash, and they put a couple of scholarships in place, $2,500 scholarships, and there's a number of smaller scholarships. And you would be very hard-pressed anywhere that you go to any kind of an event in the district that the shrimp company have not supported, Mr. Speaker. So we're very proud of them. And unlike, I guess, a for-profit enterprise, this one was built to aid the development of sustainable employment for coastal communities and to maximize the benefits from fish resources. And regarding the fishery right now, as we kind of move from shellfish to groundfish, we know that the way of the fishery of the future is going to be different than the fishery of the past. And I have every confidence that they will adapt and change and that they will continue to be a success, Mr. Speaker, in whatever they road they choose to go down. They've certainly been a leader in providing multi-species fish products throughout Canada, the United States, and beyond. So, Mr. Speaker, with that, I see that my time is gone, but I am very happy to support, pleased that the government, this was one of the initiatives in the Way Forward document. The Way Forward document, Mr. Speaker, is really just a roadmap. It's a guide. It's something for us to measure ourselves by as we go forward, which is very, very important because we do work for the people of Newfoundland and Labrador, and we must always be mindful that we have to be accountable to them, who ultimately is our employer. Thank you for the opportunity.
Hear, hear, hear.